You ever hear that voice that says, "You're a loser. You don't do anything right." Are you seriously going to wear that? No, that's not your spouse talking. That's your inner critic. It ruins your confidence, disrupts your sleep, affects your relationships, and it could even lead you down a spiral of depression and anxiety. But don't worry, because by the end of this video, you'll have a whole new understanding of the critic, one that will put the power back in your hands. And at the end, I'm going to reveal a super powerful technique that's unconventional and you've probably never heard of it before. It's a game changer. Trust me, you're going to want to stick around for that. Okay, so you ready? Let's just jump right in. The moment you were born, you were the star of your own show. Everyone adored you. Your primary duties were drooling and the occasional diaper disaster, but you could do no wrong. Now, notice the critic was nowhere to be found. He wasn't nagging you for your lack of accomplishments, or making snide remarks about your baby fat, or shaming you for peeing on your Uncle Louie. Nope, the critic was nowhere around. Now, fast forward to age 2. You went from crawling to walking upright, which is the equivalent to an adult learning how to unicycle on a tightrope while juggling flaming torches. And you did it in only 2 years. And you learned an entire language all by yourself, without any private tutors or taking any night classes. And you realize that pooping your pants is not your only option. You did all of this without some inner critic screaming in your ear how much of a loser you are. Which just proves, we don't need an inner critic to be at our best. Okay, so what's the key takeaway here? Is it 1, babies aren't ashamed of their baby fat? Or is it 2, Uncle Louie should be wearing a face guard? Or is it 3, we weren't born with an inner critic? If you chose number 3, ding, 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 correct. Okay, so if we weren't born with an inner critic, where'd it come from? Fast forward a few more years. One day, you hop in the car, thinking it's a lovely day for a family drive, and next thing you know, your parents drop you off at some big building full of other kids your age. Yup, you're on your own now. Although you didn't know the term hierarchy yet, your 5-year-old self sensed the game. Rise to the top. Suddenly, you're comparing yourself to every other kid. Are you smarter? Faster? Better at drawing in the lines? And then, bam, your teacher slaps a grade on your finger painting. The pressure's on. Your entire self-worth hinges on whether you get an A or a B in coloring. You quickly realize that the world isn't such a safe place. Making friends is a little harder than you thought. And now you're not the star of the show anymore. It's quite overwhelming for a young 5-year-old. Now this is where the inner critic comes in. He promises to be your friend. And if you listen to him, you'll be safe. But instead of being friendly and nice, he's mean and berates you every opportunity he gets. Now, he's not doing this to be mean. He actually thinks he's helping you. It's fear and shame-based tactics worked wonders back in the caveman days to keep us from getting kicked out of the tribe. But we're not cavemen anymore. However, from some of the stuff people are posting on TikTok, I'm wondering if humans are actually regressing back to our more primitive selves. Okay, so fast forward to the present day. You're at a company party, talking to someone, and you let slip a weird off-key comment. Your inner critic hits the panic button, thinking this means you're definitely getting kicked out of the tribe. But let's get real, it's not that serious. Nobody is going to remember or care about this tomorrow. You're not getting kicked out of the tribe. But your critic doesn't know this. It hasn't got the memo that we're not dodging saber-toothed tigers anymore. We're just trying to make it to Friday without a mental meltdown. Okay, so what's the key takeaway here? Is it 1, finger painting is a legitimate art form? Or is it 2, TikTok videos are a way of displaying high IQ behavior? Or is it 3, the critic is just trying to help? If you guess 2, then ding, 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 correct. I'm just kidding, it's 3. Your inner critic is just trying to help. Now, underneath all that nastiness and shame the critic loves to dish out, there's usually a positive intention. When it belittles you and tells you you're not good enough, or something is wrong with you, it's actually trying to protect you and keep you safe, or at the very least, motivate you to be better. So, for example, if your inner critic calls you a lazy fat loser who will never amount to anything, what it's really trying to do is push you to be better. It's acting like an army drill sergeant using tough love instead of a caring life coach who might use encouragement and support. But don't take its words at face value. Look for the positive intention buried underneath that harsh exterior. It's trying to motivate you. Now, once you get this, it changes everything. Your inner critic, it's actually not trying to tear you down. It's trying to build you up in its own clumsy way. It's pushing you to do better, to be better. you start to hear the real message underneath all that criticism. It's just the critic's unique way of urging you to make these positive changes in your life. Its heart is in the right place. It's just the execution that's flawed. All right, so now for that power tip I promised you. Every time your inner critic dishes out a criticism, challenge it to also give a potential solution. Think about it. It's pretty easy to point out problems, right? Anybody can do that. But when your critic throws something negative at you, stop and flip the script. Turn around and ask, okay, smarty pants, what should I do about it? This little trick does more than just quiet the critic. It transforms the entire conversation in your head. Instead of getting stuck in a loop of self-doubt and criticism, you start engaging in a productive dialogue. Imagine this. Your critic says, you're terrible at public speaking. Instead of letting that comment bring you down, challenge it. Ask it, all right, how can I improve? Maybe it leads you to practice more or join a speaking club, or maybe watch some tutorials. Suddenly that criticism becomes a roadmap to getting better. By doing this consistently, you'll notice a shift. Your inner critic starts evolving from a constant complainer to a helpful collaborator. It's not just about finding faults anymore. It's about discovering paths to improvement. This approach turns criticism into constructive challenges, propelling you towards personal growth and self-improvement. And that, my friends, is how you make the critic work for you. Okay, so just a quick recap. We weren't born with the critic. The critic is just trying to help. Look for the real message underneath the criticism. And for every critique, challenge it to offer a solution. All right, so that's the end of this video. I just want to say a huge thank you to each and every one of you watching. Your support, your comments, your time, it means the world to me. It's you guys who make all this worthwhile. Before you go, make sure to check out the very first video I uploaded. It's all about tackling perfectionism and procrastination, and I'm sure you guys will love it. Just click right over here. All right, I love you all. I'll see you in the next video.